limited technique of painting. The restoration of photographs is a recent discipline. Only in the last few decades has photography gained greater importance. Before the 1880s and the advent of mass production, the photographs were manufactured by hand. Each photographer could introduce variations during the manufacturing and use many techniques simultaneously. Therefore, there were a vast number of techniques and variations. So, each ancient photograph is a unicum. Furthermore, it is composed of different types of materials because the photograph is glued to a paper or cardboard support, which can itself deteriorate and worsen the conservation state of the photograph. It's fundamental to identify the technique used to produce the photographs in order to elaborate a restoration project. The main characteristic that distinguish the photographs is the number of layers used in production. We can have one, two, or three layer procedure. In the one, I prepared a drawing, but okay. In the one layer procedure, the image is in the fibers of the paper. An example is the salted paper print. When we observe the image closely or under a microscope, it's possible to clearly distinguish the fibers. The image doesn't have many details and is mixed with the paper's irregularities. The colors have shades of brown. About the two-layer procedure, a typical example is albumen print, which consists of one layer of paper and one layer of albumen and sodium chloride. The image is in the layer of albumen. The albumen is the deposit obtained when the albumen is beaten and let to rest. Mm. The silver nitrate is applied to the prepared paper just before using it. The photograph obtained is brilliant, sharp, with a well-defined image. To avoid the turning yellow of the albumen when exposed to the light, the photograph could be colored by watercolors or tempera, and a varnish could be applied on the surface to make it more brilliant. Finally, we can have the three-layer procedure. In this procedure, the layers are paper, barium sulfate, and the image. In this last layer, there is a binding agent, which can be collodion or gelatin. The prints obtained are called aristotype collodion silver chloride when collodion is used as the binding agent, and aristotype gelatin silver chloride when gelatin is used. The surface of the photograph is extremely smooth, uniform and shiny. The colors are warm and brown, but could also be pink and a light blue if we add pigments to the barium sulfate. The techniques analyzed so far use printing out, which means that the prepared paper put into contact with the negative is then placed in a photographic press and exposed to the light. The aristotypes are used between the years 1884 and 1930. They are then replaced by silver bromide gelatin print obtained through chemical development. It's a three-layer technique where the binding agent is gelatin and the silver salt is bromide, which reacts faster than chloride, and therefore the time for exposure and printing is reduced. The deterioration of photographic materials and photo album is due to two reasons, internal factor and external factors. The internal factors refer to the types of materials which compose the works and to the manufacturing processes and its inadequate use of chemical products. For example, a cleaning that doesn't completely eliminate the sodium hyposulfate used in the fixing can cause stains, fading, and turning yellow of the image. In the case of photographs, in addition to the image's characteristics, it's necessary to consider the paper support, which can itself deteriorate and worsen the state of preservation of the photographs. The external factors are relative to the environment in which the works are stored. First of all, the limit, that is the parameters of temperature and relative humidity, the light, natural or artificial, the air pollution, and the dust. Particularly, temperature, relative humidity, and air pollution can speed up the deterioration caused by exposure to the light and result in turning yellow and fading, especially in the pigments of color photographs. Furthermore, the human factor can cause tears, cuts, wrinkles, gaps, and stains of various nature. Incorrect restoration is also included in this kind of damages. For example, the use of glues and adhesive tape not suited for conservation and the practice of gluing the photographs on papers and cardboard with high acidity and consistency prevalently of lining. In this case, the darkening of the paper and cardboard also migrate on the image, and we often see little brown stains of foxing present on both the support and on the image. We can recognize the typical deterioration of examining the technique, which can help us to identify the technique used. For example, the subtle paper is very sensitive to the light, which can cause fading, and ultimately the image may disappear. The albumin print present the crackers on the surface, caused by different tensions between the paper support and the image, often sudden changes in humidity. A typical deterioration when using this technique is the tendency to turn yellow, mostly in the light areas, caused by the reaction between sugars and amino acids present in the albumin protein. This is the Maillard reaction. At last, the tendency of the image to roll up if it isn't glued on a rigid support. Another typical deterioration common to all silver technique is the mirror silvering. A bluish halo visible in the dark zones due to the migration of silver salt to the surface. The risotypes and the silver bromide gelatin prints deteriorate with the motionless detachment that reveals the layer of barium sulfate. Other damages include scratches more or less deep, particularly in the collodion prints, silver mirroring, especially in the risotypes and in the gelatin papers. The gelatin effect is the main catalyst action with the humidity and causing deterioration of silver salt. Finally, it's possible to distinguish mechanical deterioration, chemical deterioration, and biological deterioration. About the mechanical deterioration, we can have tears, folds, gap of the support and of the image, especially in the margins and in the corners, abrasion, superficial dip, deformation, rolling up, dust deposits and superficial dirt, stains due to the contact with the substances of various nature, fingerprints, emulsion, detachment, and bands. About chemical deterioration, we can have foldings, turning yellow of image, especially in the light zones, discoloration that causes stains in particular areas or on the wall surface, oxidizing, which causes stains, silver mirroring, and foxing. About biological deterioration, we can have colored stains caused by microorganisms like molds, bacterium, fungus, gaps caused by rodents, holes and insect traps, sediments and stains caused by insect and rodents. The deterioration of photoalbum is due to internal and external factors mentioned previously. The albums are composed of different materials, and they have the characteristics and the problems of paper materials, especially of books. Since they contain a photographic collection, the interaction between these materials must be considered. The pages inside consist of thick paper or most frequently of cardboard. The cover can be in cardboard, coated in paper, canvas, steel, velvet or wood, with a layer of ivory or metal, real artistic works. Inside, the photographs can be glued on the page or put inside the page when the page is double, becoming in this way an envelope. More often, the photographs are put in cuts made in the page in which the four corners of the photographs are placed. Sometimes, envelopes or passepartout are put on the page. The format are usually big, and the weight of the album and photograph collection inside causes the weakening of the book binding. The consequences can be detachment of section or loose sheets, the separation or the breaking or the sewing thread and of the metallic rays used instead of sewing. The breaking of canvas string used to unite the page to the back. The breaking and the separation of the materials which cover the back, paper, canvas, leather, the break of nerves on the back, all of colored ribbons put on the back to close the album. Relative to cover restoration, it's possible to have many damages caused by wear, like gaps, tears, wrinkles, abrasion, especially in case of leather. Decorative pieces falling off, for example, the ivory or the material plates, loss of color, and again, stains and superficial dirt. The main problem in the interior of the album is how the photographs are placed. Repeated placement and removal of the photographs can cause the breaking of the strips that support the photographs. When glue is used, the problem is the glue deposits and stains. The photograph, as far as the photographs are concerned, once we identify the technique used and assess the state of conservation, it's possible to plan a proper restoration project. The restoration must be documented with pictures before, during, and after. The first phase is the clean, the dry cleaning, which includes dusting with a soft brush, both the recto and the verso of the works. The paper support is cleaned using hard or soft eraser. The photograph is cleaned using a suitable eraser. The removal of insect alluvium and sediments of glue is removed with a spatula and compresses of dense methyl cellulose. The second phase is the tamponing of the image with a water alcohol mixture. When we can restore holes, tears and gaps with a Japanese tissue of suitable weight and methyl cellulose. The Japanese tissue can be colored before restoration with watercolors. As far as the photo album are concerned, we have to remove and restore the photographic collection inside. Then the phase of cleaning includes dusting with a soft brush and a suitable eraser. We can restore holes, tears and gaps with Japanese tissue of suitable weight and methyl cellulose. The Japanese tissue can be colored before restoration with watercolors. We can reinforce margins, corners and folds with methyl cellulose and with the use of weights. We can consolidate the sewing with the new threads and restore the gaps in the cover using the same material. At the end, we can reinsert the photographic collection inside with a Japanese tissue to separate them from the support. In this way, it's possible to keep the unity between the album and the photographic collection. The technique used in the manufacturing as the photograph is important also for conservation. Some types of techniques are more sensitive to the light, for example, the salted paper and all one layer technique, because they don't have a binding agent, or the album in which the image has a tendency to fade or turn yellow. In this case, it's opportune to conserve the works in a dark place, for example, a drawer. However, it's necessary to put the works into envelopes or boxes which passed the suitability test for photographic material conservation, called PAT, photographic activity test, that measures the reaction of photographs with the materials which it is in contact with, and determines the tendency of an image to fade and to deteriorate. The materials used have to be inert to the works. Their shape and size have to be suitable so that the works are properly placed. There are different kinds of containers, white paper envelopes, very cheap, porous and matte. They protect the works from the light and let the air circulate, but hide the works and can absorb humidity and gas when the conditions of conservation aren't correct. The envelopes can be composed of folded page with three open sides, with two or only one open side in which an acid-free adhesive is used and without reactive substance to silver, with four strips obtained by only one folded page. Plastic envelopes, they are transparent, so we can see the works inside. They protect them from the dust, but not from the light, and breathe less than paper envelopes. They have to be chemically stable. It's advisable to use polyester, polyethylene, and polypropylene. On the contrary, it isn't advisable to use PVC or polyvinyl chloride for material which contain chloride. The envelopes can have one, two, or three open sides, and the others closed by heat or by ultrasound and without adhesive. One sheet of polyester sealed to a paper or a cardboard that protecting and supporting the works and simultaneously allowing the work to be admired. A passepartout made of cardboard, on which the work is placed with a Japanese paper string, and a window that frames the work. The system also allows us to view the works without exercise manipulation. After the photographs are placed in the envelopes, it's advisable to place them inside boxes of various type, for example, with the fixed or removable tops. In addition to this, there is another type of box with the rings. The photographs are stored inside a number of pockets, which are kept horizontally on the shelf. We must consider the amount of photographs to be placed to avoid crowding them into a single box. The restored album can also be stored inside boxes or of adequate size and shape. Otherwise, they can be placed on the archive shelves in a horizontal or in a vertical position, depending on the available space and the conservation requirements. Naturally, if they are placed vertically, it's important to place them, taking care not to stress the binding. The conservation environment must be carefully controlled. The temperature must be kept between 18 and 20 degrees Celsius. The relative humidity must be kept between 30 and 50% with a margin of maximum 5%. The maximum lighting is 150 lux. These general parameters don't apply to certain cases, like color photographs, which require a cold and ventilated environment with a temperature of under 0 degrees Celsius. Furthermore, the photographs must not be exposed to light, even if only temporarily. In case these parameters cannot be respected, it's advisable to avoid rapid change of temperature and humidity, because they can cause expansion and contraction of the support and damage in different ways. This may cause damage to separate from the support. Finally, it's advisable to have a transitional area between the archive and the consultation areas, where the climatic parameters are intermediate. This allows the works to adapt to the gradual changes. The works must be regularly checked and dusted by a qualified personnel, so that the state of conservation can be monitored and evaluated for further restoration. Later, the material can be digitized to allow conservation in a permanent way and to allow the consultation without direct contact. In fact, the direct contact usually worsens the state of preservation of the works. Thank you.
Thank you. It was a very useful overview, I think, of the different photographic techniques and types and reasons for deterioration and methods for restoration. So, by the way, in the bebinding manual, we also have a chapter with similar information inside, if you want to read more on this topic. So, some questions probably or comments about the photographs restoration?
Do you have some, cases or have you faced some cases where in the books you are finding some photographs incorporated in the books? And what you're doing, because in some books you could see original photographs incorporated, binded in the books. So how you process them and what are the damages that may occur if the photograph is inside the book?
I prefer to keep the unit with the book and the picture, so I can restore the picture on the page, and the page if there is some degradation. but I don't. I prefer don't take away the pictures.
Okay. More questions? Thank you.